Welcome to our second episode of the Crafty Art Shack. As you can see, we're trying to get all fancy, like these other YouTubers. And we're going to zoom in now and get right to our project. Materials that you're going to need is an eraser that we got from the Dollar Tree. You're going to need your carving tools that we showed in our last video. Okay, let me put those out of the way. Move this out of the way. You're going to need some Jinga blocks. And then you're going to need a cutting mat like we have here, or a cutting board will work fine. Then you need some wood glue that came from the Dollar Tree. Our Jinga blocks came from the Dollar Tree too. Then you're going to need a knife of some sort to cut with. And I'll show you what we're going to be doing with that. And what we're making today is a block that stamps. And this is the stamp that it did. Okay, now the first thing you're going to do is, like I told you in yesterday's video, this is what we're working towards getting good enough to make these out of this type of material. Let me take you back up here a little bit so you can see. This is a speed block print block that you carve into to make these. But since I'm new to this, I don't want to be messing up these blocks like this because they're expensive. So I'm practicing on erasers like this that you get from the Dollar Tree, and I'm making this, which makes a really good stamp for a beginner that's trying to learn how to make them. So we're gonna get started. Here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna open up our knife. We're gonna stand the eraser on its end, and I like to kind of line mine up on the mat, and you'll see where it starts to curve. You want to cut this edge off, and you'll cut the edge off on this end. And how you do that is by lining it up, and then you're just going to slice straight down with your box cutter or your craft knife, and then you're just going to cut the end off like this. Okay, and then you're going to do the same on the other side. Again, I'm lining it up just so I make sure that I cut it square, because the problem is if you put your design from here to here, you're going and you go to stamp with it. If your design's on this side and you go to stamp with it, there's no support on this end. So we're going to just go ahead and get rid of that. And you just cut down and separate it off like that. And what you should have is this. Okay, now the next thing we're going to do is you need a pen or a marker or something of the sort. And I draw my stuff freehand, but if you're not good at drawing, there's a solution to this. You just need a pattern. And let's say I was going to pick one of these patterns on my sheet here. And let's say it was going to be this one right here. This one. Okay. All I would do is on this back side, I would scribble this with a pencil. With a number 2 pencil. Just scribble on the back of it. And then I would line it up on my block. And what you do is you just kind of feel for the where the edges of your block are. Make sure you got it lined side to side and top to bottom. And when that pencil's on there and you trace this, then it's going to leave a pattern onto here. But I am not going to do that. I am just going to do another feather so that I can show y'all. And I like to start up here in the corner and work my way down. So I'm going to lay the little vein of the feather first. And this works better if you're going to draw straight on the block, that you do it with and an ink pen. And then you're just gonna draw your little sections in. And I know I have that feather, but I'm gonna, I like to have different ones so that when I'm stamping, I have different stamps and I can group them together. And each one of them looks a little different. No two are the same. And it's okay if they're not the same. They're not supposed to. When you go out in nature, you don't find everything the same when you pick up leaves or you pick up feathers or whatever. Okay, now we have our design on here. I don't know if y'all can see that. Let me zoom in. This is our design. And I'm going to try to keep my fingers out of the way. Y'all forgive me if I say a lot or if I do certain things and say certain things a lot. I apologize. I am new to this and I'm really working on it. Okay, now we're going to grab our tools that we got yesterday. And the tool that I like to start with, some people like to carve away all the big part first. I like to outline it. So the tool that I'm going to pick is the one that has the little V in it. I don't know if y'all can see that. It has a V shape in it, where this one's more rounded and this one is more rounded. This one's a flat round, which it'll carve out more. This one will carve a little bit away, and this will get your fine details, the one that looks like a V. See, I don't know if y'all can see that or not. Okay, so what you're going to do is you're going to start on your material. You always want to be pushing away from you, and you don't want your hands up here in the area where you're working. Okay, and you just go right in there and you carve out the little section. When you get right here to this part, you just kind of do a little stick in there and it pulls that out. Okay, and then what you're doing is you're just basically going along here and you're following along, not cutting too deep, the outline of your drawing. And what that's doing is that's giving you a way to, my tools keep rolling here on me, that's giving you the outline that you're going to need when you come in and carve away with your other tool. And notice I'm carving away from me still. Okay, and when you get to those ends, you don't have to worry about cutting them off just yet, because sometimes when you go back in, like right here where I went back in, it cuts it off right there. Okay, and so now we got this one hanging on here and we're just going to come right here and finish up the vein of our leaf, of our feather. And you kind of just pick those little pieces out of there like that. Now, once you become really good at carving with this, it'll be easier when you get to that speed block because they carve away really fast. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go in here and carve the vein of my feather. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to start here. I'm not going to carve the end of it because that's where I need that left there so that I have something to show the end of the feather. So I'm going to start right about where the feather starts curving up, and I'm going to go in there and I'm going to dig deep. And you don't want to dig too deep. You just want to ride the edge. You want to give it enough of it. And then when you get to the end, then you're just going to pop up. Did you see that? I went along and I just popped up. And then when you pop up, that stuff comes right off like that. Okay, we're going to do this. Now, when I carve this, because I carved this already, that's going to pop right out. Or it should. Just like that. You're going to carve each one of these little lines, detail lines that you put in there, away. because when you carve those away, that's what gives it that feather look. Okay, now we've got the feather done. So what we're going to do is we're going to grab our larger U-shaped, see the U-shape, cutting tool. And what we're going to do is we're going to clean everything on the block away. Now this part of the block I didn't use, so I'm going to just take this knife that we started out with and I'm going to cut that end away and save this piece to make another stamp later on. Okay, now I'm going to come in here and I'm going to hold here where my hands are not in the way, and I'm going to start going along that first line that I carved out and cut away all of the excess, because that is what's going to create our shape of the feather. Sorry, you guys. And I'm not going to bore y'all with the rest of this carving, because pretty much what you're going to do is continue carving till you cleaned off everything like
you did. Okay, we're back and our block is now finished carving and we've glued the Jinga blocks on the back of it. Now what we'll do is we'll do like I told you earlier. You'll take and ink it up on this side, and then you're going to take and turn it over and you're going to stamp on the back, pressing it down evenly across the back and then lift it up. And you see where I didn't get any stamp stuff right there? That's because I didn't ink this good enough. And another thing that you're going to want to do when you're inking is you're going to want to wait till this dries on here. Because as you saw mine, I thought I let it sit long enough, but I didn't. And it slid on me, so I had to line it back up there. So I'm not going to try to ink any more with it, but you can see where I did different inking patterns with it. And if you'll notice, right here, I had a little line running along the edge of it. And I had to go back in and cut it away. And then when I inked again, this is what I got. Now, you do want to make sure that you completely cover your design with ink really well, and it'll stamp out darker to start with. And then some of these erasers, you need to take a sanding block and go over the design to rough it up when you're using these erasers, because they have a coating on them. But most of these erasers that I've gotten, I've just inked them a couple of times, and then from there on they did fine.
Well guys, I really enjoyed making stamps today here with you at the Crafty Art Shack, and we hope that you like and subscribe our videos, and we're looking forward to having more videos with you. Thank you, and y'all have a great day. Bye.